All right. Attorney Romulo Macalintali had good points when he said that when it comes to the Supreme Court determining form and substance, tapos na yon.
Hindi pa tapos yon. Kasi okay. The Supreme Court merely made a general statement that there were ultimate facts that constitute the alleged sufficiency in form and substance of Marcos's protest. Mm-hmm. That's why we pointed out to the Supreme Court, mali yan. Where are the ultimate facts? Where are the ultimate facts that gives the detailed specification? So we ask, in Llano del Sur, there were 39 municipalities.
Yeah.
Where are the ultimate facts in 39 municipalities? Do you refer to the two municipalities? Yeah. Then only two municipalities had ultimate facts.
So you're coming from different places. He believes the ultimate facts will be brought out during the
preliminary conference. That's why
conference.
We said, no, yeah. You cannot do that because you will be fishing for evidence for the 37 municipalities. You only allege ultimate facts in two municipalities in Llano del Sur.
You believe that's the only ones that should be open?
Yes, the only in Llano. In Basilan, there are 15 municipalities. Ang kinwestiyon niya, isang municipality. But he made an allegation in the entire Basilan, may violence, intimidation, etc. And in one municipality, he submitted evidence.
Yeah.
So we said, where are the ultimate facts in the 14? You only allege ultimate facts in one municipality. So hindi ho po pwede ito. In Cebu, for instance, a very, very big city, nagsabi siya maraming irregularities. Where? Saan nangyari yan? So, ito ang hinihingi namin sa kanila.
But,
so, we are not delaying, Karen.
Yeah, yeah.
I'd like to correct the statement of Mr.
Attorney Vic.
Because if you say we are delaying, you are insulting the Presidential Electoral Tribunal. You are insulting the integrity and competence of the Presidential Electoral Tribunal kasi dapat alam ng tribunal kung nandidelay kami o hindi.
No,
we should be cited in contempt of court.
But then, during the case of Coco Pimentel and Miguel Zubiri, weren't all the ballot boxes opened?
Almost all. But
That's the point. I mean, Coco Pimentel naman, who's now the Senate President, didn't have proof then with cheating in every single precinct, but yet all were open.
Well,
isn't that the same case?
No, it's not the same case because in the case of Coco Pimentel, he made specific allegations per province, per municipality. So there were a lot of specific allegations. No? And you know, the lawyer of Coco was Laila De Lima, and Laila De Lima was a very good election lawyer at that time. And George Garcia and I, we were the lawyer of Zubiri.
Yeah.
Kami dalawa ni George Garcia ang abogado doon. So,
but that's why you didn't succeed in making sure that the other ballot boxes weren't open. They were all open.
They were all open.
Yeah.
Yeah, they were all open.
So don't you think that will happen again today?
Well, it depends on the Supreme Court's findings or decision on our argument na there are no sufficient grounds in some municipalities. Hindi po pwede yung general allegation. You know, sasabihin na dinidelay namin. No, we are not delaying. The problem with Mr. Marcos's protest is that he had presented a very weak protest. There were so many defects in the protest. And siyempre, as lawyers, we have to point out these defects. Otherwise, we would be stopped in assailing all these defects in the protest.
Uh-oh.
Kapag hindi namin yan binrot out agad in the first stage of the case.
Okay, a viewer wants to ask, how true are the rumors or do you still trust that the PET can remain independent or is favoring Mr. Marcos?
Oh,
I don't want to use what the viewer wrote, bought by.
No,
wag naman bought by, but maybe perhaps
wag naman gano, because,
favoring.
Yeah,
no?
We always trust the competence, integrity of the Supreme Court, members of the Supreme Court. The way this case is being handled is also the same way by which other electoral protests brought before the Supreme Court had been handled before.
Mm-hmm.
The problem here is the entire cluster precincts of the Philippines are involved. This is not a teeny-weeny municipality. Hindi ito isang napakamaliit na municipality lamang na sa isang iglap ay ma-resolve agad. There are so many issues that must be resolved first before it could go on and could start with the revision of the ballots.
Okay,